Okay, Amanda, so we've been to Vancouver and we also have been to Seattle, which is very close to Vancouver. But now we're going to Japan and we are talking about a Japanese fisherman's quest. And in this article, we see that this fisherman has been through lots of obstacles because of the earthquake and tsunami that happened a few years ago. But as we look at Hiromitsu Ito, we learn that he is selling something called dream oysters. Why do you think he calls them this?
Well, we learned that he is a fisherman and that his occupation is to fish for oysters. But he's called them that because he's had to recover. So it's the dream of his recovery from these challenges, to a better life.
Okay, and in the article, Ito actually says, or the article says, Ito lost his house and three boats, but has refused to give up. That's very inspiring, isn't it, Amanda? What can we learn from that?
I think we can learn about the attitude that we have when we face challenges. Here we see that he lost his livelihood in this event, in the tsunami, but that he has hope for the future. And so our attitude toward challenges of hope is very important.
That's a good reminder, Amanda and viewers. I hope that you always remember that you should never give up, to keep going, and we hope that that applies to you learning English as well. Thanks for joining us today.